Comes out onto the backstretch, the Breeders' Crown Final. Open trotters from the downs at Mohegan Sun Pocono. There, off and trotting. Rummy Three Rivals, Top Flight Angel gets the first call. Off stride when Dunbar Hall. Two beta break from the outside. Homicide Hunter with good speed. Inside, Guardian Angel Oz drops down from the center. Marion Marauder comes up down to third as they round the turn. Crisado Delanoche floats out wide of Pinkman, who defends pylon position. Warwe Rue is next. Two lengths clear of Will Take Charge. And way behind after the break, they make their way towards that quarter. It's Dunbar Hall. They reach the opening quarter in a clocking of 27 seconds flat. They make their way towards for the first time, and it's Top Flight Angel who shows the way. Homicide Hunter settles into the pocket second. Marion Marauder found the three hole, and he's three lengths off the lead, and Zeron sends him to the outside again, flushed by Guardian Angel Oz, who picks up cover. Pinkman shoots the gap at the inside, five lengths off the lead. Crisado Delanoche's third up into the flow. Warwe Rue is fourth over. Towards the inside, Will Take Charge saves ground, way back to Dunbar Hall. Half time's on the board, 55-3. Top Flight Angel leads it by 3 parts of a length as they start up the bank stretch. Outside, Marion Marauder continues to dig in, inches forward now, second on the grind. Homicide Hunter at the inside in the pocket third. Guardian Angel Oz is perfectly positioned by Kikeli. Length and a half off the lead and now three wide. Here comes Crisado Delanoche. Inside, Pinkman is no place to go in heavy traffic. Warwe Rue's three wide with cover. Will Take Charge angles to the outsides. Only five lengths off the lead, mired in traffic. Three quarters, 124 and through it all. Top Flight Angel leads by a length. Crisado Delanoche trying to sustain out wide. Marion Marauder still battling in between horses. On the far outside, Warwe Rue up the inside. Homicide Hunter Knapp now sends him to the inside. They straighten away. Top Flight Hall up the inside. Homicide Hunter is all out. Outside, Crisado Delanoche. Top Flight Angel. Homicide Hunter is getting there. First Breeders' Crown win for Napolitano. Homicide Hunter up the inside to win. Top Flight Angel second, tight for third. 152-3 in the Breeders' Crown.
Pacers have reached the back stretch, and they are underway in the finale. Western Fame, center of the track, is leaving. Filibuster Hanover fires at the pylons. Those two go at it. Two back on the inside to Lazarus. McWicket is away fourth, four off the pace. Following that up on the inside, Rock and Ron. Delta Winner parked out. He's going to retreat to the back of the pack behind Don't Tell Me Again, and all bets off. Filibuster Hanover with the early advantage, holding down position. Lazarus is launching on the outside the quarter, 26-1. For the moment, it's Filibuster Hanover, but Lazarus moseying up on the outside now for Gingra, takes over the lead from Filibuster Hanover. Back at the pylons, Western Fame. McWicket is 4-5, and right now Sears patient with him in fourth as Lazarus has cleared before the turn. McWicket steps to the outside, giving cover there, second over to Rock and Run. Also moving out there, Don't Tell Me Again with that big late kick. At the back, Delta Winner and all bets off. But it's Lazarus, relatively unhurried to the half, 55-2. 29-1 second panel. That's one in the ledger for Lazarus. But now McWicked comes on the outside to speed him up. McWicked taking on Lazarus as they approach 5-8. Pocket seat still belongs to Filibuster Hanover. McWicked taking the lead away from Lazarus. On the outside, Rock and Ron now into third. Also moving on the outside, Don't Tell Me Again. Look at McWicked spreading out the lead to three. Three quarters, 122-2, 27 even. Lazarus is fading out of it. McWicked now leads by three lengths. Rock and Ron trying to get to him second. Don't Tell Me Again. Uncorking on the outside. All bets off fourth. Top of the stretch. McWicket is lonely on the lead. He's up by four on the outside. Don't Tell Me Again. Cutting into the margin. But it's McWicket. 4 years later, back at the top of the sport. McWicket dominates the pace by four. Filibuster Hanover up the pylons for second. Don't Tell Me Again third. Rock and Ron fourth. This rivalry was decided decisively tonight by McWicked in 1:49.3.
Stretch race 7, Breeders' Crown Final, 3-year-old colt Trotters. From the downs at Mohegan Sun Pocono. They're off and trotting. On the outside, Metz Hall with solid early speed moves out for the lean crystal fashion. Angela Downtown on the mix as well. Towards the inside, $50 bill establishes a pylon spot. And Tactical Landing floats out now for Sears. Looks to drop down in front of Evaluate first bend. Lawmaker comes away seventh, getting a spot in front of Run Director. Moves to the outside, shy of the quarter. And off stride when $50 bill. Three made a break, and on top it's Metz Hall, leading it by a length and a half. Quarters up in 27-1. Good clip here for Metz Hall, who leads it by a tight length. Julia Downtown, the long shot, settles into the pocket second. Crystal Fashion third, and Tactical Landing now dives out of fourth, now third, now second, as Sears sends him on his way with 5/8 to go. And Tactical Landing with a fourth to first brush tanks over, released by Metz Hall as they make their way towards the half. Julia Downtown still right there, third by a length. In fourth position comes Crystal Fashion, 5 lengths off the lead, and one clear of Evaluator moves to the outside. Run Director looks to save ground outside. Lawmaker has excess cover, 55-4. Tactical Landing the one to catch now. Up the back stretch, the lead is a length and a half. Metz Hall right there with a watchful eye second, starting to come under Randy Miller tap, urging now. Crystal Fashion drives up third, still 3 lengths off the lead. Inside, Julia Downtown with no place to go, fourth by 2. Inside, Run Director is fifth. Evaluate could not go on. Tactical Landing is going on. 3/4, 1:23-4. The 1-8 third quarter for Tactical Landing. Sears getting chilly. Outside, Crystal Fashion trying to grind closer. Metz Hall starts to fail in the pocket. One clear of Julia Downtown. They straighten away, and Tactical Landing is drawing away. Tactical Landing opens up by 4. Metz Hall at the inside of Crystal Fashion. They battle for place. Run Director on belatedly, but Tactical Landing just too good in the Breeders' Crown. Metz Hall may have held off Crystal Fashion for a second. Run Director rallied on for fourth in 1:52-1 on the slump. The starter has called a 3-year-old colt gelding Spacers to the gate for tonight's 12th race at Pocono, final of this division, carrying a purse of $530,000. The Pacers have reached the backstretch, and they are underway. This is the plan. Steps out on the inside, just a nose out in front of Think Big, Dream Big. Those two separate by a length from American History on the outside. Schnitzel Do Something finds positioning at the pocket there. Two back to fifth, and Dorso Duro Hanover. Grand Teton settling sixth, then Lather Up. Springsteen eighth, and away back is I'm a Big Deal, well removed from the rest. So early on, this is the plan in control. American History striving on the outside to get closer. The quarter, a crisp 26-1. And now McCarthy pushing the button for American History. Slides on past. This is the plan. Dorso Duro Hanover in motion for Matt Kakaley. Following up, a couple horses leave there. Think Big, Dream Big to the outside. Grand Teton was briefly 3 wide. Now settles in behind the cover. Lather Up now third over. Back at the pylon, Schnitzel Do Something. Springsteen is 8th behind traffic. I'm a Big Deal, the trailer. Dorso Duro Hanover with the lead at the half. 53-4. 27-3. Second panel fraction.
not for the timid here. Dorso Duro Hanover leading by just ahead. Pressure from Think Big Dream Big on the outside. Meanwhile, American History is trapped two back on the inside. Second over fourth there, Grand Teton, as Dorso Duro Hanover repelling Think Big Dream Big. Now Lather Up moves three wide for Teague. Inside looking for room. This is the plan. Also on the move, Schnitzel Do Something. Three quarters, 1:21 and 3, 27 and 4, fastest fractions we've seen all night. And Duro Hanover still looks strong now by two. He is leaving behind the pursuit. Think Big, Dream Big, Grand Teton both struggling. Top of the stretch, Dorso Duro Hanover, a command performance. His lead is now four lengths from way back. Lather Up trying to close, but Dorso Duro Hanover leaves no doubt about it for Matt Cacalli, winning by 4.25 lengths. Lather Up was second. This is the plan. Third, Schnitzel Do Something. Fourth, but Dorso Duro Hanover was having none of that. He gets it in 1:49 and 4 in the muck here tonight at Pocono.
Trotters all set for Breeders' Crown action. The bounds at Mohegan Sun Pocono, they're off and trotting. An in-between rivals, Caprice Hill and Emoticon. Hanover shows speed, and if Happenstance is on the early scene too, Ariana G floats up wide of Broadway Donna's, back to fifth as they round the turn. Barn Bella comes away sixth, and Link Clear of Celebrity Ruth followed by Pink Pistol and Ice Attraction trails. Heavy activity up top. Emoticon Hanover drives up wide of Caprice Hill, and right behind her is Ariana G. It's Emoticon Hanover taking over. Ariana G is right on the Dubay helmet, opening quarter 27-1, and Emoticon Hanover has the lead, but it may be short-lived as Ariana G drives up the challenge now. Back to third is Caprice Hill. A link back fourth and a Happenstance as Ariana G has been released with a circuit to go. Broadway Donna's fifth and Miller steers her to the outside. Barn Bella picks up cover. Seven improving lengths from the front. Two clear of a pylon to Celebrity Ruth. Ice Attraction moves to the outside of Pink Pistol. He's got a ball to pass and 12 to come. Shy of the half, Ariana G braces for the bid of Broadway Donna, who's up to the leader's wheel. Halftime fifth, 56-4. Big time rating. His business will pick up now. 29-3 rating on that second quarter. And it's Ariana G who leads by a half. Outside, Broadway Donna grinds closer second. The Emoticon Hanover in the pocket third. Outside, Barn Bella's been towed within striking range. 2 lengths off the lead. Fourth, Caprice Hill. And from far back, roaring up now, Ice Attraction. She is already up in the fourth. She is gaining with giant strides as Ariana G has the lead. Ice Attraction looking for the last to first sweep. 3/4, 125. 5-2. Outside, Ice Attraction up to engage. Ariana G who counters. Inside, third Emoticon Hanover. The rest of the outer flows deteriorated as they straighten away. Ice Attraction, can she sustain it? Big odds. Inside, Ariana G to the outside, Emoticon Hanover. Up the inside, Caprice Hill. It's Ice Attraction. Outside, Emoticon Hanover hones in. Emoticon Hanover does it again in the Breeders' Crown. Ice Attraction was second. Caprice Hill found room late to be third. Then NF Happenstance in 154-1.
It's Ice Attraction. Outside, Emoticon Hanover holds in. Emoticon Hanover does it again. Ice Attraction.
Have reached the back stretch, and they are underway. The inner third all firing early on at the pylons there. Twinkle, Sharton right alongside. Call Me Queen Bee just a length back. Representing on the outer group there is Caviar Alley into fourth past Lakeisha Hall. Followed there by Pure Country, who's away sixth. Followed by Carol Z-Tam. Then comes Newborn Sassy in the early trailer here. Blue Moon Stride and the early dust up for the lead, won by Sharton. Takes him to the quarter here, 26-1. Smoking opening panel here in the slop, laid down by Sharton at 1-2. So Tim Tietrich deciding to control the pace early here, leads it by a length and a quarter with Twinkle tracking from the pocket. Lakeisha Hall kicking on the outside. Matt Kakaley trying to prevent Sharton from an easy lead. Inside fourth, Call Me Queen Bee. Caviar Alley now jumps out second over. Pure Country will have a third over journey. And inside, Carol Z-Tam at the back, Newborn Sassy and Blue Moon Stride. The half mile, 54-3, 28-2. Second panel, Fractions Honest and then some, as up front, Sharton trying to get away from the pursuit. On the outside, the first over by Lakeisha Hall, now within three parts of a length of the lead and inching forward. Great trip worked out for Zeron with Twinkle. Second over, Caviar Alley is two back. Call Me Queen Bee saving ground. Pure Country third over, a lot of traffic to overcome there. Then Carol Z-Tam, Blue Moon Stride, Newborn Sassy trails, three quarters, 123 even, 28-2, third panel. Lakeisha Hall continues to pester the leader, Sharton in the pocket. Twinkle, Pure Country coming up out wide, top of the stretch. It's Sharton with a host of horses behind. Twinkle takes aim in the passing lane. Now Caviar Alley in full gear outside. Sharton starting to feel it. Caviar Alley all out. Sharton digging deep. Sharton's gonna dig in here and get the win here. Sharton, tough on the front end, said none shall pass for Tim Tietrich.
Philly Trotters straighten out onto the back stretch. The Breeders' Crown rolls on the down. It's Mohegan Sun Pocono. They're all set. They're off and trotting. Off stride, I'm Pink 2. 9 meter break right at the word go. Atlanta from between horses moves out for the lead. Manchego was put into play earlier. Inside plunge, Blue Chip moves out. Phaetosa left and now Brennan grabs hold. Supergirl Riley moves through along the inside, defending pylon position. This will force Phaetosa to drop in fifth. And she's five lengths off a battle up top nearing quarter one. Lily Strides in early sixth by a length, racing in seventh, looking for Zelda. They reach the opening quarter in a clocking of 26-4. Good speed up top. And forcing the lead change now, Atlanta. Atlanta's on the retake. Here comes Manchego attacking now. Plunge Blue Chip released for pocket position third with 5/8 of a mile remaining. Supergirl Riley is three lengths off an emerging battle fourth. Phaetosib's biding her time from fifth as they make their way towards the half. Towards the inside in sixth position comes Lily Stride. That one just flushed Phaetosib out of fifth. Back to seventh looking for Zelda. Five lengths clear of Courtney Hanover. Way back on Pink 2, 54-2. Up the bank stretch they go. Atlanta's clear by a length now, three parts. Outside, Manchego's fighting the good fight. Plunge at Blue Chip to the inside third. On the outside, Phaetosa is strong on cover. Only two lengths off the lead, fourth with 3/8 of a mile remaining. Supergirl Riley looks for racing room at the inside fifth. Lily Stride is third up and six away, looking for Zelda's box to the inside. And Courtney Hanover has excess cover, but it's still Atlanta. Three quarters, 123-4. Around the far turn they go. Atlanta starts to create separation. Plunge Blue Chip second. Phaetosa went three wide around a fading Manchego, who spent after the tough trip. Lily Stride tries the rally on four wide. And the stretch they come. It's still Atlanta by two. Plunge Blue Chip is out for the drive. Room up the end for Lily Stride, who's gaining quickly up the inside. Atlanta has to hold off the upset-minded Lily Stride, who's moving powerfully with fresh legs. Down to the finish. Lily Stride up the inside at 31-1. And Tietrich goes back to back in the Breeders' Crown. 153-2.
Pacers have reached the back stretch, and they are underway. On the inside, Alexis Power fires early. In between horses, You Are My Candy Girl coming up, and out wide, Kissing in the Sand. Early three-way dance here, and You Are My Candy Girl strikes the front. Back on the inside, Double A Mint, followed by Percy Blue Chip, fifth. Next up in the order, Strong Opinion. Dance Blue settles seventh, right in front of Baron Remy in the early trailer is Solitary. Kissing in the Sand on the outside, trying to get to You Are My Candy Girl. They rip up the opening panel in 25-4. They are churning up the slop here as Kissing on the Sand is going toe-to-toe with You Are My Candy Girl, and these two have to go around again here. Alexis Power right in the pocket behind the stifling pace. Inside fourth is Double A Mint, and now stepping to the outside, Matt Cacaley with Percy Blue Chip trying to attack the top two. Strong Opinion follows that. Dance Blue is seventh. At the back now are Baron Remy and Solitary. They get to the half, 53-3, 27-4, second panel. Merciless fractions here. Up front, it's a slight lead for You Are My Candy Girl, but still Kissing in the Sand is antagonizing on the outside. Alexis Power tightening up in the pocket. Second over, Percy Blue Chip in prime pouncing position for Cacaley. Boxed in fifth, Double A Mint just needs some racing room. Third over, Strong Opinion. After that, Baron Remy, Dance Blue, and Solitary. Still anybody's race. 3/4 and 1, 22-2. It's softened on the back to 28-4. You Are My Candy Girl, Kissing in the Sand, still inseparable. Second over, Percy Blue Chip. Meanwhile, on the inside, Alexis Power lagging. Top of the stretch, You Are My Candy Girl, slight lead. Kissing on the Sand, relentless here. Out wide, Percy Blue Chip getting into it. They're three across, Kissing in the Sand, You Are My Candy Girl, Percy Blue Chip. It's Matt Cacaley and Percy Blue Chip at 50-1 for the victory. Kissing in the Sand, so game, just couldn't hold it together late. Up late, Dance Blue for third, and that was Baron Remy for fourth. And Percy Blue Chip lights them up here in 151-1.
Don't stop me now. Don't stop me.
The only nine is the two-year-old village. Final Breeders' Crown from the downs of Mohegan Sun Pocono. They're off and trotting. Stella Jane spotted them too. They're on the inside, Woodside Charm, the favorite, wants to control her own destiny. She immediately moves out for the lead. When Dubs Cry secures the early pocket seat, as Cloud Nine Fashion drops in behind, and the Ice Duchess looks for a place to reside fourth and will get the in front of Champagne Jane. Followed in next position by Special Honor. Outside, Whispering Oaks is seventh by one. Mishu Kelly is eighth, and Stella Jane, after the less than desirable beginning, is 10 lengths away from leader and favorite, Woodside Charm. She got the opening quarter, 27-4 in the goo. And Woodside Charm is up by a length. Wind Dubs Cry, a more than patient pocket sitter second. Cloud Nine Fashion bites her time from third, and she's too clear of the Ice Duchess, who gaps fourth at 3/8 completion. Champagne Jane gets a bit tighter fifth now, as McClure thinks about right lining her. She flushes the Ice Duchess from fourth. Special Honor moves to the inside sixth, looking to shoot the gap. Whispering Oaks is right behind her seventh. Length back to Mishu Kelly eighth, and still trailing Stella Jane, about 10 lengths off the lead. 57-1 at 29-2. Expert rating there for Woodside Charm, who's up the back stretch, one clear of a clear. Wind Dubs Cry outside the Ice Duchess needs to pick up her ball game. She's 3 lengths off the leader. Towards the inside, Cloud Nine Fashion is pinned down fourth with less than 3/8 to go. Special Honor is no place to go fifth. Champagne Jane needs much more off her cover. Whispering Oaks is next as they round the turn. Woodside Charm has confident lead, 3/4 on the board. 125-2, 28-1 for the split. Woodside Charm is 1/4 to go. When Dubs Cry is tightening down in a large center to the outside, now it's on. Cloud Nine Fashion moves up the inside third. They straighten away for the stretch drive. Woodside Charm, when Dubs Cry on the outside attacks now. Cloud Nine Fashion tries to get up the inside mid-stretch. Woodside Charm is confidently handled by Verlin Yoder. When Dubs Cry second, Woodside Charm does not disappoint. She takes the Breeders' Crown. Second, Wind Dubs Cry. Finishing third, Cloud Nine Fashion. Then Special Honor, 154-1 for Woodside Charm. And yes, she is for real.
Supersonic man out of you. Don't stop me now.
The Trotters have reached the backstretch, and they are underway on the outside early speed from Green Manalishi. Chimpanzee leaving right in the center of the track. In between those two is Super Shizzle. They're three across, and tucked right in behind are both Hudson River and also Prospect Hill. Moving up into sixth from the outside there, that is Kings County improving position. Off stride went Prospect Hill. Smartest Hill is sixth, a gap back to Tricks and Stones at the back of the pack. The quarter mile in 27 and 3, and coming away with the early lead, Green Manalishi worked his way up from that outside post. Pocket Seat belongs to the heavy favorite Chimpanzee, and not any longer. Quick move there right to the front to take over the lead from Green Manalishi. So now Chimpanzee calling the shots on the outside. Kings County has been parked. Back at the pylons there, fourth, Super Shizzle. Now that's Chin Chin Hall, second over into the fray. Back at the pylons, Hudson River, third over, but rough gated. Smartest Hill is now off stride at the back there with Prospect Hill. The half in 57 and 3, 30 even second panel, so fractions reasonable here. Chimpanzee going along with no urging whatsoever on the outside, trying to move up Kings County. Green Manalishi still has second in the pocket. Brian Sears taking a quick look back inside fourth. Super Shizzle on the outside, second over Chin Chin Hall, moving up slightly to within three. Also on the outside, Tricks and Stones, inside Hudson County, then Prospect Hill. Three quarters reached 126 and 3, 29 even third panel. Middle portion of the race was Stay Puff Soft here. That's good news for the leader, Chimpanzee. Green Manalishi still lurking in the pocket. Now room for Super Shizzle on the inside third. Top of the stretch, Chimpanzee looking to put away. Green Manalishi is second, but losing ground now as Chimpanzee opening up for Brian Sears. Chimpanzee still perfection, winning the Breeders' Crown here by 2.5 lengths. Green Manalishi chases him home in second on the inside. Hudson River for third. Super Shizzle fourth. But Chimpanzee, as expected, in the Breeders' Crown Final in 154 and 4/5.
Treacherous Rain. There goes Queen of the Pride moving out for the lead towards the inside. Saint Somewhere along the inside. Beauty on the Beach moves through as well. Zero Tolerance floats and hopes as they race around the first turn. It's Queen of the Pride who has the lead by a length. Treacherous Rain settles down into the pocket. Here comes Zero Tolerance pressing forward out wide third. Beauty on the Beach defends pylon position at the doorstep of quarter one. Saint Somewhere is fifth by a length. Tall Drink Cannibals to the inside of War Wee U Butte, and she is on the move now. 26 and 2 sharp quarter for the slop, and up on the outside, here comes Zero Tolerance, who takes the lead, but Saint Somewhere is right on the scene, and War Wee U Butte is right behind her with 5/8 to go. Saint Somewhere looks through yet another lead change, and will. She's past Zero Tolerance. Up on the outside, War Wee U Butte now takes same third, second as they make their way towards the half. Up on the outside, Prescient Beauty, an extremely live outer flow, moves up wide of a pinned down Queen of the Pride, who once had the lead and is now fifth. Tall Drink Cannibal was involved in the outer flow. She's 7 lengths off the front. Of a 54 2/4 back to the top where War Wee U Butte has taken over now. Saint Somewhere is second by 2 lengths. At the inside, Zero Tolerance is third. Prescient Beauty starts to labor out wide fourth. In behind her fifth, Tall Drink Cannibal, still 5 lengths to come nearing 3/4. Queen of the Pride is pinned to the inside sixth. Annie Hill takes up third over position. Treacherous Rain is shoveled all the way back to last now as Beauty on the Beach moves around her. 3/4, 122 and 4. Midway around the final turn, War Wee U Butte, it's hers to win or lose. Outside, Prescient Beauty is finding another gear at Big Odds. Inside, Saint Somewhere is third. Towards the inside, Zero Tolerance is pinned down. They straighten away. War Wee U Butte by a length. Prescient Beauty to the outside. Zero Tolerance trying to re-engage. Outside, Saint Somewhere mid-stretch. War Wee U Butte. Zero Tolerance. Prescient Beauty. Beauty on the Beach from far back. War Wee U Butte down to the finish. War Wee U Butte wins the Breeders' Crown. Tight for second. 152 and 3.
The Pacers have reached the back stretch, and they are underway. The Two captains leaving in the center of the track, led by Captain Crunch, who steps out now. Captain Trevor, a notchback. Meanwhile, on the outside, Blood Money, aggressive early, taking it to Captain Crunch. Inside fourth, Proof, and parked out for the moment there. Air Force Hanover. No Massamore is away sixth, followed there by Alliance Johnny Jr. at the back of the pack. Love Me Some Lou in the trailer. Man Go, and Blood Money was able to make the front end from the far outside post and clicks off the quarter in 26-4. Yannick Gingron, Blood Money early on, but now Captain Crunch pulls the pocket here for Scott Zeron. He's on top. Proof is on the move on the outside at 9-5 for David Miller with Designs on the lead. Back on the inside, Captain Trevor fourth as Proof does take the lead, looking to clear before the turn. To the outside now goes Tietrich with Air Force Hanover. Following up that move, No Massamore, and that outer flow got shuffled a bit wide there as Captain Trevor came out. Back on the inside, Love Me Some Lou at the back of the Packer Lions, Johnny Jr. and Man Go. The half 55-1, 28-2 second panel. Proof was able to clear as he rounded that turn. He's up now by a length over Captain Crunch. On the outside, Captain Trevor gaining slightly from McCarthy within a length and a half with the first over move. Blood Money now blocked in fourth, but not too far off the pace. Second over, Tietrich has Air Force Hanover in striking position. Third over on the outside, No Massamore. Then Love Me Some Lou at the back, Lions, Johnny Jr. and Man Go. Three quarters, 1:23-2, 28-1, third panel. Proof still leading the way by a length, trying to separate, but Captain Crunch still engaged in the pocket. Captain Trevor is dropping back. Late kick outside from both Air Force Hanover and Love Me Some Lou way out on the wide side. Top of the stretch, Proof with the lead. Captain Crunch pulls the pocket for Scott Zeron, and Captain Crunch blows right on past Proof. It's Captain Crunch pacing away at the end by three lengths to win it here. Proof back to second. That was Love Me Some Lou on the inside, sneaking through for third. No Massamore fourth. Captain Crunch pocket trip to pay dirt in 151-3.